Let us now discuss about power and series RLC circuit. Here you can see the three components are in series across an AC MF and say an instantaneous current I is flowing here. We can directly write the effective current in the circuit can be directly written as IRMS is equals to ERMS by Z, where Z is the impedance of the circuit. And if we know the value of IRMS, we can directly calculate the power in circuit, power consumption. If we talk about, we can directly write, as we know, inductor and capacitor never consume any average power. Power is only consumed by the resistance. So your average power can be written as IRMS square R, as inductor capacitors do not consume any power in this situation. And here we can see, if we calculate the power by a general relation, that is IRMS, ERMS, cos phi, where cos phi is the power factor that can also be used. But this average power will only be consumed by resistance. So for any circuit, average power can directly be written as the total power consumed by the resistances of the circuit. These two will give one and same thing, because in this situation, if the overall circuit impedance is Z, then we can directly write ERMS is equals to IRMS multiplied by Z by using Ohm's law. So if you substitute ERMS over here, you can see it is IRMS square Z cos phi. And from impedance triangle, you know well that Z cos phi is equals to the resistance of circuit, which is IRMS square R. That's why I have directly written the power consumed by a circuit as the total average power consumed by all the resistances of the circuit. Here in this situation, you can see power in circuit will be maximum when the value of cos phi is 1. And we know the value of cos phi is 1. When Z is equals to R, which we can write, this is the minimum impedance of the circuit. As IRMS is ERMS by Z, when Z is minimum, IRMS will be maximum, and correspondingly the power in circuit will also be maximum. And we know Z is equals to R at a resonating situation. So here we can write, at resonance, when the value of angular frequency of alternating current matches with the 1 by root LC, the value of Z becomes R, and correspondingly we can write, at resonance when omega is this, circuit current as well as power will be maximum. You must be very careful about the phenomena regarding power. Let's continue on the next sheet. As we have just now seen that power in a series RLC circuit is given as IRMS square R, and this becomes maximum at resonating frequency, which is 1 by 2 pi root LC. Now, if we just draw a variation curve of power with frequency, say now I draw power with the variation in angular frequency of oscillation, then we can directly state that omega is equals to omega R, that is resonating frequency. The value of power becomes maximum and the curve looks like this shape. And again at resonating frequency, the power is maximum. Similar to this situation, we define an important concept over here, that is the frequency where power reaches half of the maximum, or this is the situation when the RMS current is maximum by root 2, because when IRMS is equals to maximum by root 2, the power will be half of the maximum. And this happens at two frequencies, one is omega 1 and other is omega 2. So these are the two frequencies where power is maximum. So the range of these frequencies, which we define as delta omega, which is omega 2 minus omega 1, in between, the power remains above the half of maximum. This is defined as bandwidth of the resonating circuit. Here we can define a term, that is bandwidth of a resonant circuit, In case of series RLC circuit, we can define the range of frequencies omega 1 to omega 2, where power of circuit is more than half of maximum is called circuit bandwidth. Application of this bandwidth you will see when we'll study about the topic of communications and the transmission of signals over higher carrier frequencies. We'll study what is the role of these bandwidths in a specific circuit. But right now it is important to understand what I mean by bandwidth of a resonance circuit.